In this video, we will take a look at absolute and comparative advantage. I'll start with absolute advantage. The following set of assumptions hold for our discussion on absolute advantage and comparative advantage. Remember, in economics, we deal with models, and it's highly unlikely this model would describe a real-life situation. Firstly, we assume there are no transportation costs. Second, that production costs are constant. We assume there are only two economies producing two goods. The goods are homogeneous, which means they are identical. Factors of production are completely mobile, and there is full employment. There are no tariffs or barriers to trade, and there is perfect knowledge. While these assumptions are asking a lot, they are a necessary condition of our pending analysis. Moving on to the theory, we start with absolute advantage, which exists when a country can produce more of a product per unit of resource, land, labor, capital, and enterprise, than another country. In this table, we can see the output for two economies that produce only pizza and widgets. They can produce either widgets or pizza. To find the country with the absolute advantage, we look for the country that produces a greater amount with the given resources. With regards to pizza, it's country X. With regards to widgets, it's country Y. Comparative advantage exists when a country is able to produce a product at a lower opportunity cost than a trading partner. Instead of absolute advantage, where we look at the country that produces the most, we look for the country with the lowest opportunity cost. Using the output method, I will show you how to calculate the opportunity cost of production for each good for each country. Let's restart with the basic table from the beginning. First, we'll consider country X. I've added two new columns for the opportunity cost for each good. For pizza, we can see that country X can produce 50 pizzas or 100 widgets. That means every time they make one pizza, they could have equally produced two widgets. If the opportunity cost of one pizza is two widgets, then with the resources used to produce each widget, we could have produced half a pizza. So our opportunity cost of a widget is 0.5 pizzas. Continuing with this approach, the opportunity cost of pizza in country Y is 5 widgets. And finally, the opportunity cost of a widget is 0.2 pizzas. To determine who has a comparative advantage in production, we find the country that has the lowest opportunity cost. In other words, we find the country that sacrifices the least amount of the other good to determine what they should specialize in. In this example, country X has a lower opportunity cost of producing pizza, so they have the comparative advantage in pizza, whereas country Y has the lower opportunity cost and therefore comparative advantage in widget production. We'll use this information to explain the trading possibilities curve in a later video. Once again, if you have any questions or comments, do leave them below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com or visit the website at www.enhancedtuition.co.uk. You can also tweet me at enhancedtuition. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.